Hello, hello, hello! How are we all doing? How are we all doing? Happy Monday! Hey Liz! How are you? Hope you've had a good weekend. Everybody's had a good weekend. We are back, hopefully, finishing The Crow. As you can see, I've just got the wing and the tail feathers to do. Happy birthday, boy, mum. Well, it's not his birthday until tomorrow, but yeah. I've just said to him downstairs, I said, how does it feel that you're going to be 25 tomorrow, James? I said, you're almost half our age. And he just went, oh, shut up. But yes. Hey, Faisal. How you doing? So we've just got the wing and we've just got the tail to do and something for this bird to be sat on, because at the moment it is just sat on air. It's sat on nothing. So that's what we're going to be doing. So let me just reorient myself with all the lines. Right, so here, have this feather. Okay. So this section here is made up of 1, 2, 3, 4 overlapping feathers. So, first three are quite low down here. So, if we have the fourth one sort of coming down at like that angle, I'm going to use the edge of this paper just to sort of help me make sure I'm getting a kind of straight-ish line. Right, now I've got a sort of blue slightly. Right. half a month. Half a month? What do you mean, half a month? Half a month of what? Oh, a 15 stone. Okay. Sorry, it just takes. It's Monday. It's Monday. Just bear with me. Bear with me while I sort of catch up and sort of work out the math. But yeah, it is weird knowing that, you know, tomorrow I will have a 25-year-old. That is very weird. There's a moment when you've got four kids under the age of five that you just don't ever think that you're going to get out of that. You just don't. You just can't see the end of that chaos and exhaustion and sleeplessness and overwhelm that you'll ever get to the stage where actually they're all adults. And now I've got to that stage where, like, you know, James is going to be 25 tomorrow. The twins are going to be 24 in November. And Jack's going to be 21 in December. And it's like, all four of my children, I don't have any teenagers left. All four of my children are responsible adults. And it's just, it just blows your mind sometimes, because for a long time there we were in the trenches, so to speak, in the trenches trying to survive. I mean, normally we have a tradition in our house that whoever's birthday it is, then they get to choose the meal for the day. And normally the last few years, the kids have all asked for, like, they just want, like, a roast dinner with, like, all the trimmings, and that's what we've done. But James has asked for McDonald's. So, yeah, McDonald's. So that's two of us that can't eat it. So me and Becca can't eat it because they don't do anything that's gluten-free. So I don't know what Becca and I are going to have. We'll probably just make our own things. Ow! Oh, just hurt my foot then. This is weird going back because I'm doing the lion on the pastel mat and it's quite a textured paper. It's very strange going back to this smooth Bristol board. Oh, we had a nightmare last week. I forgot to say. Oh, we, what was I doing? Friday, it was just one of those days where everything that could go wrong went wrong. And it all culminated with, I had to go out somewhere in the car. And I got in the car, drove out of our road, everything was fine, and turned onto the main road. And the car, a light came up on the flashboard in orange, and the sort of engine warning light. And the car literally went into limping mode. It would not go above second gear. You could not get above 10 miles per hour. It was like kangarooing. It was doing this no matter what you did. And I was just like, oh God. I managed to limp my way to my appointment, causing traffic because I was going so slow, and parked in the car park of where I was going. And when I got out of the car, I just had to text Nick and say, look, this having this issue with the car, you need to get here, bring your RAC card or something, because there's no way we're getting this car back home. And so he turned up and he got in the car and he said, look, he says, I'm gonna try and get it to, I'll take you home. And then I'm going to try and get it to the garage where we take our cars. And so he got me home and limped the rest of the way to the garage. And they're very good there. They look after us at this garage. They know us. We've been going there for years. And so the guy sort of plugged in his diagnostic machine. But there was nothing coming up on the diagnostic machine that said, there doesn't seem to be anything that's coming up on our machine about your car. So the guy said, just go out and drive it again and just see what it's like. And so Nick took it round the block and it went back to normal. And and the light disappeared. It went back to normal. So he took it back to the garage and said, yeah, it seems to be fine now. It's really weird. And so they were like, well, maybe there was a blockage in the exhaust pipe or something, and you've cleared it and everything's fine now. So he was like, okay, great. So he drove the car home, and we thought no more about it until Saturday morning, when I had to go out again. And I got back into the car, went to the end of our road, turned onto the main road, and the car went back into limp mode. The orange warning light came on for the engine. Could not get above 10 miles an hour. I was sort of kangarooing down the road. So I just hit a left and hit another left and hit another left so I could get back to the house. And I walked in and I went, well, it's doing it again. And it was like, oh, so we phoned up the garage and yeah, we've been told not to drive the car, but they cannot get our car into the garage until the 23rd of September. The 23rd! They have such a backlog of work. They are so booked up. Can't get our car done until the 23rd of September. So yeah. Not a happy bunny, not a happy bunny at all. It was just something that came on the end of a long day of things going wrong. And it was like, are you kidding me? Seriously, now the car, it was just when you think everything is going well, so I'm hoping that when it does finally get seen by the mechanics and the engineers, that it's something simple. But it just seems that at the moment we're staggering from either something wrong with the animals or something wrong with the car. There's just always something going on, and it's really, really annoying. Because Rosie, our adorable golden retriever, Jamie, your client, keeps somehow managing to grab hold of socks and swallows them before you realise that she's got them. And then, obviously, on the Friday evening, this was after the car had broken down, we were about to serve her a dinner and she vomited loads, and she brought up two socks in the stuff. Sorry, TMI. And it was like, for goodness sake, everyone please be careful. Please don't leave socks on the floor because our dog is so stupid. She is going to make herself ill, or she's going to give herself a blockage and she's going to end up having to go for emergency surgery because she's going to block her gut. So we did that, and then obviously the car, there was some other stuff going on that I'm not going to go into. And then it was like, just when we thought we'd got a handle on everything, I took her out for a walk this morning. And she went to toilet. And there was a sock in it. I don't know where she's getting them from. I honestly have no idea where she's getting them from. But if anyone wonders where the socks go missing, my dog has them. So if you have a problem of missing socks in your house, it's my dog. I'm sorry. It's my dog. She's getting hold of them somehow. She's not getting them from my house, but somehow is still managing to eat them. So she must be getting them from your house. Trying to think which bit to do next. I'm trying to layer things on top of things. So if I do this underside bit, then I can layer the bit on top, which would seem to make the most sense. Right, so here I found a light inside me. I wanna let it glow. Keep shining. what they ask you. Right, so under here, like a dark patch.
Shelter in the storm. I'm hiding in the blue, safe between the clouds. In the blue, where I can't be found. Was a soldier in the legions, fought against the demons, fought against the monsters made of gold. But they stormed across Arcadia, following their nature, washed away the place I once called home. I'm hiding in the blue.
The other thing I did on Friday, I had a complete and utter brain meltdown. I had so much stuff going off, and I'd completely forgotten that I had agreed with my editors that I would turn in my work a month early, on September the 1st instead of October the 1st. And so I was just sort of sitting on this story thinking, oh, you know, I don't have to send it in for a whole month. I can relax. And she emailed me and said, you know how you said you were going to give the work in on September the 1st? And I was like, oh, something vaguely rang in the very cobwebby depths of my memory that yes, I had actually agreed to hand the work in by September the 1st. So I scrambled to get that done and get that sent in so that it was good enough for my editor's eye. So yeah, a lot was going off on Friday, and I had so much stressful stuff going off that I just thought, you know what, I can't do stream as well. So I cancelled stream on Friday just because I was just having one of those days where everything was going wrong. And I just thought, you know what, just be kind to yourself and just don't do stream. And so I didn't do stream. And I think I ended up playing Doom for like for like half an hour or something, because I downloaded it but hadn't got around to playing it. And I was just like, right, just go do something new. Go and do... I do kind of like Doom. I think I just need to learn all the controls first, which is why I haven't shown you me playing it yet. I want to get all the game controls and the settings worked out in my head. Because they've got certain keybinds, and I kind of want all the keybinds to be the same no matter what game I play, so I don't have to be thinking about how to change things over. So I spent some time changing all the keybinds, but then I had to There's some extra instructions almost. So I've started reading this really good book. I'd seen it out and about, so to speak, for ages, but I did the thing they always say don't do. I judged the book by its cover. And I kept looking at this, even though I'd heard that this book was really good, I kept looking at the cover and thinking, does not inspire me to read it. And I've been so wrong. So wrong. The book is In Memoriam by Alice Wynne. And it's set in the First World War. Let me just find, see if I can find the book blurb for it. In Memoriam, Alice Wynne. And it's set, like I say, it's set during the First World War. And it's about these two public school boys, basically, one called Elwood, one called Gaunt. And they're at school together in the preceding years before World War I starts. And they're kind of in love with each other, but they didn't say anything to each other because obviously, you know, back then, being a homosexual was something that you could be, you know, arrested for, and it wasn't something that was out in the open. And then these two boys end up enlisting to go and fight in the war, and they find snatches of humanity and comfort in love with each other in between the brutality and the horrendousness of the trenches in the war. And oh, it's so good. It's a debut book, and this is the blurb. It says, in 1914, war feels far away to Henry Gaunt and Sidney Elwood. They're too young to enlist, and anyway, Gaunt is fighting his own private battle, an all-consuming infatuation with the dreamy, poetic Elwood, not having a clue that his best friend is in love with him too. When Gaunt's mother asks him to enlist, he signs up immediately, relieved to escape his overwhelming feelings. But Elwood and their classmates soon follow him to the front. Elwood and Gaunt find love in the trenches, but just as war has brought them together, it can also tear them apart. An epic, unforgettable love story between two men in the First World War, In Memoriam, is a breathtaking debut. And oh my God, I'm loving it. I'm loving it. It just pulled me in from the first couple of pages, and I should never have judged the book by its cover, and Becca told me off about that today. She says, you always say don't judge a book by its cover, and that's exactly what I did. I should have paid more attention to what people were saying. I should have given it a chance. And I mean, now I have, obviously, and it is just such an amazing, amazing book. And I'm loving every moment of it. So if you're stuck for an idea for a book and don't know what to do, then might I suggest In Memoriam. I mean, it's been a long time since I've actually read a book in full because I've just, I don't know, I've been in a bit of a reading slump, I think. And so it's been really nice to find a book that I can actually allow myself to get involved in and enjoy. I think I might recommend it to my brother, actually. 'Cause he likes reading historic books, and I think he would like this one. Nearly there, nearly there. Right, I'm just sort of... just going to track these feathers. So that one... This goes just slightly shorter than the feather beneath it. Oh, this is so. This is so... finished piece for a while, so this will be good to get this finished and up on the old TikTok and the Insta. I'm nearly just a couple hundred away on the TikTok. How many exactly? I'm at 835 followers on TikTok. If I can get to 1,000, so another 165 to go, if I can get to 1,000, then I'm allowed to stream live on TikTok. So I kind of want to get up to that because I would really like to just stream some of the art on TikTok live. I think that'll be fun. Oh, I'm pleased with those tail feathers. I quite like how that's come out. Right, I need my right. Where do we think we are? I think I'm considering that done. I don't know where to sign my name on that one. So if I put it down the edge of this tail, it's going to look weird. If I put it under its feet, it's going to look weird. Whether to just put something in the corner or whether just to leave it blank. I don't know. I did hear one artist give one trick where you get this sort of paper that's see-through. And you put your signature or your name or whatever on it, and then you just sort of move it around so you can see where it might look the best. So I might try that later. But yeah, there we go. There's the Crow. That's been a fun little draw. I've enjoyed doing the Crow. They are my absolute favourite birds. And they're so clever and they're so intelligent. And I just think they are so gorgeous. When you see that shimmer of colour in their feathers, you know, when the sunlight hits them and you get that shimmer of colour, I just think that that is just beautiful. But yeah, there's our little crow. So that's not too bad. Let's do... Before we go, let's do... Hang on, let me get rid of my iPad. Bear with. What am I sat on? Let's finish off with the puzzles. Because I've not done these. Wow, let me move that. Actually, no, I can sit there. So, four groups of four. So record, store, weird reaction, stamp, station, letter, comic, funny, mail, coin, post, off, position, curious, job. Stamp duty. Nothing else is duty. Stamp collection. Coin collection. Record collection, record, stamp, coin. What else would be a collection? Comic? This is probably going to be wrong, but... Oh, I was right! Oh, okay! I thought there was no way that that was going to be right. I was just random. Okay. So, weird, funny, off. Mail, reaction, post, curious, strange, peculiar. Okay. Post office. Mail office. Station office. Mail, letter, post. No. Station, position, post, job. That's got to be right. Yes, okay. So reaction, letter, mail, and store is what? Chain. Oh, yeah. Chain. Chain letter, chain mail, chain reaction, chain store. I'm going to sneeze. Or maybe not. Okay, so that's not too bad. So, mini, professional, inner, don't know what that is. I'm not a robot. Love in Italian is amore. Eight wards off fence, possibly. Secret rendezvous, can't think. Craft to it's going gone. Don't know. Dark wood is going to be ebony. Focuses on the road. One might be multiple choice. Don't know. professional in the secret rendezvous is going to be a tryst. It's going gone. Focuses on the road. Yay. Okay. So then we've just got one left to do, which is strands. Order in the court. Learn. No. Okay. Order in the court. It's like things that you're going to find in a court. So there's no barrister there. There's no solicitor. It's a lot of Q's. What are these Q's? Q-U. Queen, square, okay, sires, okay, earl. Oh, right, okay, so positions in a court, right, okay, so viscount. So that's got to be Duchess, Knight. So this has got to be Sir. Not gonna get Baron. Oh, we are. Okay. Oh God. Okay. So titles backwards. Okay. And what, squire? Oh no, esquire. Esquire. Yes. Okay. What's happening now? Oh, brain. Brain is not working. So, okay. So, that's it. That's where I'm going to leave it today then, chat. Thank you so much for joining me with watching me finish off The Crow, which I'm quite pleased with. I really like the tail. There's so many lines in a wing. But, yes, we finished The Crow. So that's all good. So the only art project that we've actually got on the go now is The Lion. But yeah, I might be doing... That's really dark. Why is that really light? Hang on. There we go. That's not so bright. It's because I had a white screen in front of me. Yeah, I might be doing some sort of inking project. I've got some ideas. I'm going to be working on creating something of my own. So, sort of like Zentangles, but in a more geometric mandala-ish kind of way. So, I need to buy myself a compass, though. First, before I can do it, if I want everything to look good. So it's because I did these. I was playing around with these, which I showed you on, was it the Thursday or something? So to make these, you actually draw a grid and you pencil in the lines, and then once you've got your pattern sorted out, then you go over it in ink and then you erase the grid. So it looks like you've been really, really clever and everything, but it was great fun to do that. And I've been seeing some other tutorials on YouTube that I quite like the look of, so I might be doing something along those lines. But anyway, that's where I'm going to leave it for today, chat. Thank you so much for joining me on this lovely Monday evening. I hope you have a great rest of your evening, and I will see you tomorrow around about 5:30. Okay, bye.